What is going on, everyone? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Jocelyn J, and in today's video I'm going to be talking about some updates that I made to my Dell XPS 15 dual monitor setup. You can think of this as a 2.0 version, especially for those of you all who watched my previous Ultimate Dell XPS 15 setup. And in this video, I'm gonna be talking about more of the ergonomics and storage and counter space updates that I made to my desk. At first, I didn't know if it was necessary to actually make a new video about some updates that I made, especially since I haven't upgraded my computer or my monitors, but I realized that my setup looks very different, especially because the countertop is much larger than my previous one. I actually have storage units and I have a new chair that Autonomous AI sent me, Ergo Chair 2, that I'm very grateful for, and I'm going to be making a more extensive review on that soon, so stay tuned. I think sometimes we get so caught up in the technology and those upgrades that we don't realize that the counter space, the storage units, the chair is just as important when it comes to productivity, effectiveness, and overall quality of your work environment. The main purpose of this video and this series is to take you all on this journey of building the perfect space. So what system I use that works, you know, best for me. Right now the dual monitor display is working great, but I'm gonna talk about a little bit later how I think an ultra wide display would be more effective, even though I am a programmer. And also I hope these videos give you all inspiration so you can figure out which system and setup works perfectly for you. And I honestly really love the interior design aspect of desk setups and home offices, especially since I'm gonna be working from home for the foreseeable future. So when it comes to the actual monitors, I still have the 27-inch dual display, Dell U2717D monitors. Those are the precise name. Really felt like there was no need to upgrade those, at least not at the moment. They're perfect for everything I'm looking for in a monitor. The resolution is great. The color accuracy is amazing. They can rotate with a 360-degree range. You can tilt them however you want. And they're overall just a great functional and versatile monitor. For those of you all who are new here and aren't sure which Dell I'm using, or just maybe forgot because there's so many different numbers, I have the Dell XPS 15 7590. This is the 2019 version. 4K OLED display, beautiful. It's been a great laptop. I switched over from the MacBook Pro. Not really regretting that at all. I'm still trying to get used to Windows 10. And as you can see, since I have a lot more counter space, it still can get cluttered, but nowhere near what my other desk was like. But since I have more space, I have more room for actual plants. I don't have, you know, three or four plants on here. I typically just have like one. So I'll swap out this plant with this plant, you know, whenever I feel like it. And then I have, you know, I still have these fake IKEA plants, which are really solely for aesthetics. And yeah, having more counter space just makes a difference. I love integrating my, you know, office setup with nature. And yes, friends, I'm still using the same LED light from Taltronics on Amazon. Love this thing. You can also charge devices and you can change the hue and the intensity of the light. It's a great, great lamp. For those of you all who are new here and aren't sure which Dell I'm using, or just maybe forgot because there's so many different numbers, I have the Dell XPS 15 7590. This is the 2019 version. 4K OLED display. It's been a great laptop. I switched over from the MacBook Pro. Not really regretting that at all. I'm still trying to get used to Windows 10. For the countertop upgrade, I decided to go with the 74-inch Eckbacken countertop ash effect laminate. IKEA's kitchen countertops are very durable. They don't bend in the middle and work perfectly with the Alex drawers. As I mentioned earlier, my previous countertop was only about 48 inches long, which definitely isn't enough space for someone constantly using two different computers while working from home. One of the main reasons why I chose this particular countertop is because I like the contrast and relaxing effect of white and wooden combinations, which makes the space look more vibrant and upbeat, an essential characteristic for a creative. As far as the storage, I mentioned earlier that I focus on the desk itself for this upgrade iteration, so IKEA's Alex drawer was a must to finish the countertop and drawer combination. IKEA Alex drawers are among one of the most popular items IKEA has to offer, so I was very lucky to find these drawers for retail in store. Alex drawer with four units are the drawers supporting my countertop, and I chose this version of the Alex drawer not by choice, but simply because the five unit drawer was sold out. These are a little bit more expensive because of the filing storage option, as a fourth drawer that I really use just for cords. If you are someone who stores a lot of paperwork, then this version would be perfect. The only issue is that it's a bit more difficult to build than the five unit drawer. The nice thing about going with a countertop and drawer combination is how customizable it is. So if you want to change the surface, color, or the size of your countertop, it's really easy to swap the countertops out. And I'm pretty sure all the countertops work perfectly with the Alex drawers.
I also got this really, really dope like wine glass thing from Kith, because I went to New York City about a week ago, and I love this. Keeps everything hot and cold. I think keeps everything hot up to like 9 hours and cold up to 3 hours, or vice versa. But this was a collaboration with Kith, and I think it's called Quirksicle. But yeah, they designed this like wine glass, and it's really cool. 16 ounces. I know I'm going on a rant, but I love the contemporary design of this mug slash wine glass, whatever you want to call it. I'm also still using this J5 USB 3.0 multi-monitor cable. The only issue I have with this adapter is that it only allows one monitor to have 4K resolution. Unfortunately, this Inland monitor mount, I can't find it on Amazon anywhere, so I just add the link to the store that I actually purchased this from. But it's a great monitor, great mount, like way better than the Vivo one that I had previously. A bit more expensive, which makes sense because it's a dual monitor mount, but it's very, very stable. Give you all some behind the scenes. You can see that our countertop is so cluttered, and but this scene is gonna be like this setup is gonna be like my normal setup. I think I'm gonna have the tripod right here, got the box light right there, got the old Linmon desk right there, and then I got my old chair right there. I think that's a nice setup because since this window is right here, as you can see, it's so overexposed, and it's difficult to get the right lighting when I'm facing this way, because I just feel weird because my desk is, you know, it's vertically along the wall, and it's not, it's not horizontal along the wall this way. So I figured it would be better to have like the setup facing here, and I can get lighting from that side and this side. So yeah.
Also, shout out to Logitech for sending me their powered 3-in-1 dock. This thing has been amazing. I never realized how much I needed or would use a 3-in-1 dock as much as I have, but it's great to be able to charge my AirPods, my iPhone, and my Apple Watch, which are three essential items that I carry every day. The design of the 3-in-1 dock fits perfectly with the aesthetic I'm looking for, because it only requires one outlet to charge three devices. So I can go to bed with a peace of mind. I can focus on my work with a peace of mind, knowing that I will have a fully charged iPhone, Apple Watch, and AirPods. Also, the 3-in-1 dock has helped a lot with organization, being able to grab all three of those essential items whenever I leave the house and not having to look all over for where they are. So that concludes this video. Shout out to anyone that made it this far. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it at all. Comment down below some of your office items, some of your favorite monitors or whatever keyboard and mouse you use or whatever laptop you use. I love to hear about your setup. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I'd love for you all to become a part of the community. And as always, I hope you all have a blessed rest of your week. I'll see you all soon. Peace.